Hey, this is Keeping It Real with your host, Justin Villarreal, and today we're going to be talking about some more NBA trades and trade rumors, more so trade rumors and potential trades more so than anything else, as the trade deadline is, I mean, it's like still decent away, but it is nearing. As time goes on, we get closer and closer to the trade deadline. There's more rumors swirling around the NBA world as things are starting to heat up in the NBA season. We're into December, the thick of the NBA season, and there's a lot of trade rumors to talk about with the Indiana Pacers in specific, as they have announced they're going into a rebuild and they are going to be trying to trade away three of their top players, Caris LeVert, Miles Turner, and Domantas Sabonis. And today we're going to be talking about where all three of those players can go, where they're most likely going to be traded to, and what Indiana can get in return for these three players. Let's start off with the worst of the three, Caris LeVert. I see him going to the Suns. And Caris LeVert, in my opinion, he fits best as someone who can come off the bench and can get some buckets off of the bench. And that kind of fits what the Suns really need, because when you look at a team like the Phoenix Suns, their starting lineup is pretty set. They got Chris Paul, they got Devin Booker, Mikal Bridges, DeAndre Ayton. They're all doing their thing. You got Jay Crowder, Cameron Johnson. He's a nice power forward. But the thing with the Suns is, and we've seen this with them last year in the playoffs, is it's not just their starters, but it's their bench players. Like Cameron Johnson, he comes off the bench a lot. He is that sixth man. Cameron Payne, he is struggling a little bit now, but he was someone that was able to come off the bench and be very, very good for the Suns and come up when it was needed for them. You know, Dario Saric, he's currently hurt, but he's played a big role for the Suns in the past, coming off the bench and making an impact. The Suns, they're just known for having guys that can come off the bench and make an impact. And I think that Caris LeVert kind of fits into that and can just be another addition to the Suns team of bench players that can make an impact off the bench, because that is where the Suns dominate in basketball, is when the second unit comes in for both teams. The Suns have always, or at least recently, have always had one of, if not the strongest second units. And I see them adding to that second unit, getting Caris LeVert and strengthening their bench for the playoffs, because that's what's going to be needed if they're going to beat the Golden State Warriors. It's going to be depth for them. It's going to be guys can come off the bench and get buckets. When the Warriors second unit's out there, the Suns' second unit is going to have to outplay the Warriors' second unit, and Caris LeVert's going to help with that. Now, who I see going to Indiana for Caris LeVert? I see the trade being Jalen Smith, also known as Sticks, and this upcoming 2022 first-round pick for the Suns. They're going to Indiana for Caris LeVert and Torrey Craig, the former Phoenix Sun. I think that he's going to return to Phoenix in this Caris LeVert trade, and the reason why is because Torrey Craig, he is somebody that if you are a playoff team, you want him on your bench. And Indiana, obviously, they're not going to be making the playoffs, but I don't really see someone trading for Torrey Craig individually. So I could see Phoenix asking for Torrey Craig to be thrown onto the end of this deal. And I think that Indiana would be willing to do so, because they're not really going to use Torrey Craig anyways. And so Torrey Craig, Caris LeVert, going to Phoenix for Jalen Smith and a 2022 first-round pick from the Phoenix Suns. That's the way I see that trade going down. Moving on to the next player, Miles Turner, the shot-blocking center, a defensive anchor. And I see him going to the Bay Area, going to the Golden State Warriors for James Wiseman and 2022 first-round pick from Golden State. And this move would put the Warriors over the top. It'd really be between them and the team we're going to be talking about with Sabonis in a little bit. But you got, with the Warriors, you got Steph Curry, Klay Thompson, Draymond Green. We know what they could do. And the one thing that the Warriors have always really needed, their one hole throughout their years of dominance, has been the center position, having someone to be that defensive anchor, that star center. And I think that Miles Turner can be that. That's why they drafted James Wiseman. But James Wiseman, while I think that he can be a very good player, his timeline is not up to speed with the timeline that the Warriors have right now, trying to win right now. I think that it's going to take James Wiseman a few years to really develop and find himself and really get into his own as a player. And I think that somewhere like a rebuilding Indiana, where they could kind of build around him, is a better spot for James Wiseman than a contending team like Golden State. And with Miles Turner, he is someone that is a win now center. You can win now with Miles Turner. And I think that the Warriors, they would do it. Now, it would make the Warriors a scary, scary team, because they would be almost no flaws, really. Because you got Steph Curry, he could shoot it out the gym. So can Klay Thompson. Draymond Green is a great defensive power forward. The one thing that the Warriors really lacked was a defensive anchor at center. Miles Turner would be that for the Warriors. The Warriors, in my opinion, if they make this trade, they're going to the NBA Finals. And who are they going to play? They're going to play the Chicago Bulls, who are going to trade for, in my opinion, Domantas Sabonis. Kind of similar to the Warriors. The Bulls need a power forward. It is their glaring need. They had Patrick Williams playing power forward. Then he went down with a wrist injury in a very highly contested game against the New York Knicks in October. He's most likely going to be out for all of this season, if not most of this season. He is looking to return later in the season. Hopefully he can return and have a speedy recovery. But kind of similar to James Wiseman, it's like Patrick Williams and James Wiseman, they're similar in the sense that it's like they're going to need some time to really develop themselves into the players that they hope to be, to where their potential is, meeting that potential. It's going to take them a few years to do so, as it does most players. And the Bulls and the Warriors, they're trying to win a championship right now. So having young guys that they can't really, like, they can't have as big of an impact on the game as you would want them to, having those guys starting for you if you're a contending team just doesn't make a lot of sense. So that's why I think that Patrick Williams, Kobe White, and Marco Simovic, Kobe White, and Patrick Williams going to Indiana for Domantas Sabonis. Now, I have heard some Bulls fans make the argument that Arturis, the Bulls president of basketball operations, he wouldn't want to trade away his first ever draft pick in Patrick Williams, and he wouldn't want to trade away Marco, who he also picked up in that same draft. However, I disagree, because at the end of the day, it's all about winning championships. And if you can win a championship by getting Sabonis, and you got to give up Marco and Patrick Williams and Kobe White to get Sabonis to win that championship, you do it. You have to do it, in my opinion, if that is on the table. If Indiana's going to accept that trade, and you know that's going to win you a championship, I just don't see why any executive in the league would not do that. Not only that, but, you know, with Arturis, he obviously, when he was in Denver, he drafted Nikola Jokic. He comes to Chicago. Who does he get for his center? He gets Nikola Vucevic, both European centers. Sabonis, he's also a European player. And so I just think that Sabonis being a European player, kind of Arturis' style of player that he likes to have on his team, and playing the power forward position, which the Bulls need desperately, I just see that being the reason why Arturis would, number one, be willing to give up guys that he really values in Marco and Patrick Williams for Sabonis, but also why he'd be interested in the first place in going out and getting Sabonis. And that is why I think that Domantas Sabonis is going to the Chicago Bulls. And that is all for today's video. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more sports content. And I'll see you all in the next video.